How does QuickBooks calculate interest from customers? In our previous video, we determined that Betty's finance charge would be $59.84 on January 31. Well, how do we know that's right? How do we know exactly what QuickBooks is doing to calculate the interest and find that number? Well, in order to know that, you have to know five phrases, and they're common sense and very simple. Let's call the invoice balance, meaning the amount the customer owes on that specific invoice, let's call that the amount owed on assessment date, because January 31 was the day that we stopped and assessed the interest. The annual rate is the percentage that we put in to the preferences window when we were setting up the finance charge. That's the rate of interest that we charge. The annual interest is actually the money amount that the customer would pay in interest if the balance of the invoice stayed the same for one whole year. And of course, the balance of any invoice is not going to stay the same for one whole year. So what you would then have to do is multiply it by the fraction of the year that the money was owed. So let's call the fraction of the year the part of the year that the money was owed on that invoice. And let's call our final answer the current interest. You could also call it the amount that QuickBooks charges the customer and records on a separate invoice. So I set up an Excel spreadsheet with these five items to help explain how QuickBooks calculates the interest charge. And each of these words should be common sense. When we take a look at the open invoice report, we see that QuickBooks made an invoice in the amount of $59.84 because that was the interest that was charged just for these two invoices. Right now, the open invoice report says all, meaning it's showing the results of all open invoices regardless of date. However, if we change the date in the report to the assessment date, to the date that we calculated the interest, by the way, after you change the date, you have to go all the way to the right and click refresh. And now that we refreshed it as of the assessment date, you can see that on January 31, Betty owed $3,000 for invoice number 6, and Betty owed $4,000 for invoice number 4. But more importantly, on the day that we assessed the interest, the invoice number 6 was 25 days old, and on the day we assessed the interest, invoice number 14 was only 4 days old. So we're only charging Betty for 25 days worth of interest for invoice number 6, and we're only charging Betty for 4 days worth of interest for invoice number 14. Let's take a look at how this would look on an Excel spreadsheet and see if we can calculate the same result, $59.84. So here we have an Excel spreadsheet with each of the five terms that you need to know in order to make sure that you're calculating QuickBooks interest correctly. The first invoice that was due on the assessment date was $3,000. That was invoice number 6. And the second invoice that was due on the assessment date was invoice number 14 for $4,000. Or I believe it was invoice number 14. Yes, it was. Okay, now, the annual interest is the balance on the assessment date times the annual rate. So, if the balance on invoice number 6 stayed the same for the whole year, this cell would be equal to the balance of the invoice times the annual rate. So if the balance of invoice number 6 stayed the same for a whole year, Betty would owe us $720 of interest just for invoice number 6. What about invoice number 14? Well, that annual interest is equal to the balance of invoice number 14 times the annual rate. So if the balance of invoice number 14 did not change for 1 year, then the annual interest or the interest Betty would owe just for that invoice would be $960. However, they did not owe this money for an entire year. Each of these invoices were only owed for a fraction of the year. When I go back to the open invoice report, I can see that invoice number 6 was only owed for 25 out of 365 days. So this cell is equal to 25 divided by 365. When I hit enter, I get a very big decimal. I know that some of the people watching this video are going to suggest that I change the number format into fraction. However, the reason that I will leave it as regular number is because, I will leave it the way it was because Excel's fractions are limited to the number of digits they can put in the numerator and denominator. We have 3 digits, as you can see up here. We have 3 digits, and therefore Excel won't show it in the cell the way it shows it up here in the formula bar. What's the fraction of the year for the next invoice? Well, when I look at the open invoice report, I see that the $4,000 invoice 14 was only owed for 4 days as of the assessment date. So that means that this fraction of the year is equal to 4 divided by 365. And of course, we get the big decimal. Now, the current interest, or the interest that is owed just for this period, is equal to the amount that they would owe for the year times just the fraction of the year that they owe it. So Betty owes us $49.32 just for the $3,000 invoice. And of course, it's the same for the next invoice. The interest that they owe for the current period is equal to the amount that they would owe for the year times the fraction of the year that they owe it. And therefore, the amount of interest that Betty owes just on the $4,000 invoice is $10.52. When I take the sum of both, you can see that Excel tells me that the total money that Betty owes for just January 1, for these 2 invoice balances for this fraction of the year, is equal to $59.84. And when I go back to my open invoice, you can see that the invoice QuickBooks generated on January 31 was $59.84.